Hey YouTube, what is going on? This is iTalk. What's here, and in today's video, we have a brand new video. So I was going through some old pictures of mine online, and it made me really reminisce about the older seasons of Fortnite. I really kind of noticed that with all the Battle Pass skins that we now have from all the way from Season 2, there is a lot of skins that I never see ran, and there's a lot of skins that I don't see getting the praise that I feel like it should have gotten. And in this video, I'm going to be going over one skin from each season that I feel like was underappreciated for the time and now. So starting with Season 2, we have the Blue Squire. I feel like the Blue Squire is one of those skins that no one runs, no one cares about, and it's kind of just overshadowed by the Black Knight. Whenever you ask someone in Fortnite, like, what's your favorite knight skin, it's either going to be the Red Knight or the Black Knight. It's rarely ever Blue Squire or Royal Knight. Now, I like Royal Knight as well. I just wish with, like, I'm going to mention this here with Season 2 and Season 3. I really wish they did not do a male and female counterpart to each other in the Battle Pass because it felt kind of lazy. Now, yes, I know Season 2 was the first ever Battle Pass. I'm not even giving them issues with that. Blue Squire and Royal Knight look way too similar to one another. It's just with skin tone, and that's literally it. I think Royal Knight is kind of a cult classic, I guess you could say. I'm kind of referring this as like it was music or something. But it's one of those skins, Royal Knight, I feel like people do use it from time to time. I've seen it in some pro players' streams and stuff like that. So I don't think Royal Knight is really that underappreciated, but Blue Squire, I feel like, deserves a lot more credit than he deserves. Sparkle Specialist is already too overrated in my opinion, and Black Knight, I mean, I can't even go on with you telling you how much I think this skin is massively overrated. Great skin, but it is so overdone and so overused that I had to give this one to the Blue Squire as one of the most underappreciated skins in the Battle Passes, especially for Season 2. For Season 3, we have the Reaper. Now, this one's going to be kind of interesting because back in the day, the Reaper skin, or John Wick, the unofficial John Wick, was one of the most intimidating skins in the game. If you saw this skin in your game in Season 3, the guy was gonna build on top of you, he was gonna build 90s, even though I'm pretty sure 90s didn't even exist back then, you were going to lose the fight against the Reaper. That is how intimidating this skin is. Nowadays, not so much. No one really even runs this skin. No one really cares about this skin. It seems like ever since the release of the official John Wick skin, it's almost like we kind of forgot about this guy. Like, he was the tier 100 now. Granted, I will admit, while Season 3 is probably my favorite season of all time because I just have the most memories with it, I firmly think that it actually had the weakest battle pass ever. I mean, you had two astronaut skins that no one really liked. You had the Dark Voyager, which a lot of people liked. You have Elite Agent, which is now a really sweaty skin nowadays. You also had Rust Lord, which also kind of got like a cult following as well. And then you have the Reaper. Yeah, I don't see anyone running the Reaper anymore. And it's kind of upsetting because he was once the definition of a sweat skin. And now there's so many skins like that it's not even relevant anymore. So kind of a shame, but I do think the skin was very cool for the time. But now it's kind of just being overshadowed by so many other skins in the game. For Season 4, I wanted to mention Squad Leader. I don't think anyone really likes this guy whatsoever, just the character model himself. I don't think many people like him, whether it's the hair because it is kind of different, whether it's just the outfit he's wearing because it's kind of plain. I don't necessarily know, but I think Squad Leader was one of those skins that no one ever bat an eye to. Season 4 actually had a pretty strong battle pass. You had skins like Carbide and Omega, which, I mean, we still have conversations to this day, especially on Twitter and Reddit, about the Omega lights and the Carbide lights. Like, people still want those lights to come back. It's pretty interesting with that kind of conversation that we still have that even to this day. You have skins like Battlehawk, which was really unpopular. No one cared about it. I don't even think it's that great either. Then you had Technique, which is fantastic. Then you had Zoe, which is my personal favorite from Season 4, most likely, if I had to take a guess. But with Squad Leader, he was one of those skins that you unlocked it and you never used it. At least I think you probably did not use. It's not that bad of a skin, but I do wish people would give it more of a chance because I do think it's not that bad of a skin whatsoever. For Season 5, we have the Rook skin. The Rook skin is honestly one of the best Battle Pass skins in my personal opinion. It is so aggressive looking, it is so intimidating that I think it's a skin that is just being slept right now. Like, no one's running it, no one's using it. If you've played Season 5 and you have this skin, I would probably recommend you guys give this skin a chance again, because this is one of the most intimidating skins in the game, just from the look and the stance and the confidence that this skin has. Yes, it's a skin in a video game, why am I taking it so seriously? I'm just telling you, I think it's supposed to be like the female John Wick, I guess. I don't necessarily know if that's what they were going for with this one, but I think it's a very good skin. I think this was Aiden's main at one point as well. It's such a good skin. I feel like no one's really caring about it or running it, or people even forgot about this one, which is really a shame. I think Rook is probably the most underappreciated skin in that battle pass. Like, yeah, you have Huntress, but I don't even like Huntress. Redline is just a female burnout, which I like. It's just, I don't know, I feel like too many people either like it or don't like it. Then you have skins like Sunstrider, which is also pretty decent. Sledgehammer looks really cool. The battle pass for Season 5 was not bad. I mean, you had Drift. Drift is the most overrated out of all of them, but I think it's still a good skin, don't get me wrong. But yeah, Rook, I don't think anyone really cares about that skin anymore, and it's honestly a huge shame. For Season 6, I put down DJ Yonder. When I first saw DJ Yonder in the teaser pics and everything, I thought this was going to be the Tier 100 skin. I'm dead serious. You can honestly go back to my Season 6 Battle Pass overview video that I did, and you'll see, I was genuinely surprised that DJ Yonder was actually a starter skin. It's honestly very cool. I love how flashy it is. It looks very vibrant, and I don't really understand why people don't really like this skin that much. Like, every Tier 1 skin from each season is considered the bot skin, and he looks like a robot, so that makes it even funnier. I think this skin is highly underappreciated, and I think people should give it more of a chance. For Season 7, we have the onesie skin. This was in the leaks. People were so hyped up about the onesie skin, and I personally think that the hype was kind of justified because it's a very unique skin. Yet again, this was a very good skin in the Battle Pass. I think because it was Battle Pass, people really didn't like it as much as they were hoping to like it. Because when you put something in the Battle Pass, you're pretty much knowing that the skin is going to be used a lot, because Battle Pass skins are some of the most common skins used in the game. My general rule of thumb is that if I don't see someone running a skin that often, I will typically wear it. So for Battle Pass skins, it's kind of hard for me to justify it because a lot of people run Battle Pass skins. This is my own personal take, by the way. So don't be like, oh, I shouldn't wear Battle Pass skins. This is all just my personal opinion on it. Basically, what I like to do is I like to wear older Battle Pass skins as the seasons progress. Like right now, I've been running Rook, and I will probably be running onesie more because I don't see anyone running it anymore. It was once a very good skin. Everyone really enjoyed this skin, but now it's just kind of fallen to the wayside, I guess, and I have not much else to say about it. I would highly recommend you give some of these older Battle Pass skins a chance if you do have them. Season 8, Lux. Without a doubt, Lux is the most talked about in a Battle Pass. I think for a fact that Lux is one of the most controversial for a Battle Pass, and I'm going to explain why. So Lux was a Tier 100 skin, which I firmly believe it should not have been a Tier 100. However, it is still one of the most aggressive and best looking skins for a battle pass I think we've ever had. The edit styles were very kind of pointless. They were just color edit styles that you just had to survive for. Very simple to get. She also came out with a harvesting tool that basically rivaled the studded axe for being one of the most quiet pickaxes in the game. And she also came with a really taunty emote called Fierce, which I actually love that emote. I think it's very good. Kind of toxic in a way, but I still think it's very well done. Lux is a good skin. I think it is a very good skin, but did it deserve Tier 100? I don't think so. I think this easily could have been a Tier 1 or it could have been somewhere else, but that does not deter the fact that I think that Lux is a very, very good skin in the game, and I feel like it is underappreciated for the sense that everyone just thought it was kind of not worth being a Tier 100 skin. And then for Season 9, we have the Stratus skin. I was also running this skin earlier yesterday as well. Stratus is a very good skin. I don't know why no one runs him. You know, Season 9 wasn't that long ago, so I feel like that people could be using this skin still. And I think Stratus is just one of those skins that, I mean, it got an overtime edit style that I don't even really like that much. I like the default one more. I don't know, it's just a cool skin. Like, the hoodie looks really cool. I love how drabby the clothing is with all the holes in the pants. Like, and the fact that he came with a back bling that actually shows the map with the circle on it is actually pretty cool as well. I feel like no one runs him, and I feel like no one even cares about Stratus. And Season 9 to me was probably one of the weaker battle passes, same with Season 3. Really underappreciated as well, and I wish people would give it more of a chance. For Season X, we have the Ultima Knight. This was so hard for me to figure out, like, which skin from the battle pass I thought was the most underappreciated. It was either going to be this or Sparkle Supreme, but I understand why Sparkle Supreme is not as liked as much as some of the other skins. It's due to the fact that out of all the other skins they could have picked to make it look the least amount like the other skin, Sparkle Supreme looks way too similar to Sparkle Specialist. I give a pass to everything else. Ultimate Knight's edit style is coming very, very close to Black Knight, I will admit that. But with everything else like X-Lord and Catalyst, at least they look a little bit more different than the other skins, and I feel like that can be kind of justified. But with the Ultimate Knight, I feel like it was a skin that no one ran, and I feel like it was also kind of the reason why I don't see Black Knights very often. When you see this skin and you know that people are getting this skin, I feel like people from Season 2 were going to be upset that the Black Knight was pretty much being handled this way by making another knight but look a lot like the same skin from Season 2. And I don't really get the frustrations with it because it's not the exact same skin as Black Knight, but I can't control what the community thinks. I'm not trying to put words in the community's mouth whatsoever. I'm just going off of based off what I see online. And I feel like because of the Ultimate Knight, it kind of killed any momentum that the Black Knight actually had, except for that season. I feel like I saw a lot more Black Knights during Season 10 because they're like, oh, look, we have the Black Knight even though you're wearing the Ultimate Knight. I don't know. It was a very weird time for Fortnite with that Battle Pass and that season alone. I really don't even want to remember that season. Yeah. And then lastly, we have Chapter 2 Season 1. And I'm going to be honest with you, from the Chapter 2 Season 1 Battle Pass, I don't think any of them are underappreciated. I really thought about this one for a while. I genuinely think that all the Battle Pass skins from Chapter 2 Season 1 were very well done. Everyone feels like they're a character. They don't feel like just skins anymore. And they did a really fantastic job. I mean, maybe the weakest skin is probably the fusion skin. And I'm not even saying that as like it's the worst skin of them all or anything. There wasn't much going on with it. It felt like too many other skins that I've seen in other video games, which is kind of a bad thing, at least to me. I don't know, but the Battle Pass skins were so solid last season that I really think that it's really tough for me to say which one was the most underappreciated, because I don't think any of them really were underappreciated. And that's kind of it for the video today, guys. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this little video. If you did, let me know with a like, but only if you enjoy the content. Subscribe to the channel if you're brand new and turn on the bell just for all my latest uploads. And comment down below, what is your list of each season skins that you think are underappreciated? I actually would love to know. Follow me on Twitter at ITalkFortnite. Follow me on Instagram, ICanTalkFortnite. And if you would like to use me for support a creator, my code is ITalkFortnite. Thank you all so much that use that code. It really does help me out a ton. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you all later. See ya.